Hello and welcome to Endzone Tonight and Election 08. On the 8th of November, you will decide how you want the country to be run for the next 3 years. Here on Endzone Tonight, we're asking political representatives for their policies on the issues we think are relevant to New Zealand families. So let's see what our politicians have to say. Louisa Wall, Labour, Heather Roy, ACT, Dr. Jonathan Coleman, National, and Paul Adams from the Family Party. Welcome. Thank you for joining us. Tonight's topic is on health, and we'll be looking at the concerns of community leaders on the current public health system. At the end of the program, each of you will have the opportunity to sum up your policies. Louisa, going to you first, could you please tell us what the priorities are for health for the Labour government?
Priorities for health are our young people and our old people. It is also about making healthcare affordable and accessible to all people. So we've really focused on cheaper doctor's visits. On average now, $26 to visit your doctor, and there's a million New Zealanders who get to see their doctor for under $16. Obviously, under six-year-olds get to go to the doctor for free. So we've had a huge emphasis on making the health system a lot more accessible to our people. I think the flip side to that is also a huge focus on prevention. So in terms of immunisation, for example, there's been a 77% in immunisation of our young children. We need to ensure that our young children get a good start to life. And then at the other end of the spectrum, as you will know, or the voters will know, we've had 7,500 more cataract operations, 10,000 more elective surgeries, mostly focusing on hips and knees. And for us, it's all about a free, public, accessible, good quality health system. We've got 1,000 new doctors, we've 3,000 new nurses in the system. So the bureaucracy has grown. I mean, obviously the health budget when we came in was just under $6 billion. It's now $12.2 billion. There has been an increase in staff in the Ministry of Health, but that's been capped at 1.8% of the total spend.
Bureaucracy is a big thing. If I can just turn to Heather Roy, looking at bureaucracy and the DHBs. 21 DHBs for 4.2 million New Zealanders. Is that too many?
Yes, I think it probably is. We've got services being replicated up and down the length and breadth of the country. And my objection to the district health board system is that what it's done is inserted an extra layer of bureaucracy into the health system at great cost, actually, and taken funding away from frontline services, which obviously isn't what we want. We want the best quality health services in the best time at the best cost. You know, we're talking
about
taxpayers' dollars.
We're
talking about taxpayer dollars, and we need to be accountable for that spending. An extra $6 billion has gone in, but we have had very little in the way of increased productivity for that. And when we're talking about public services, that should be the core thing that we're trying to get as much as we possibly can for taxpayers' dollars. The district health boards are a phony democracy, if you like. People put their name forward in good faith, thinking they're going to represent their local populations, but the instruction that they get when they turn up at their first meeting after being elected is that their sole role, their one role, is to implement the government of the day's health policy. That's not what we want. They were set up to represent their local populations, get the best services for them, and I think that the system's failing in that regard.
Paul Adams, phony democracy, your view, please, for the Family Party.
Well, on the democracy, in regards to health, are you talking about? Well, from the Family Party's perspective, we recognise that a lot of our health issues are caused by things that would be outside what we would call the recognised health system. And what we're concerned with is the results on the front line. And as we just heard from Labor, have spent an excess of $6 billion more than what they were when they went into government. And yet our frontline people, which I believe are very hardworking and very well respected, are really struggling to get results. And that is because there is too many layers of bureaucracy. And even when you come down to simple things like the cleanliness of the hospitals, which is obviously a health issue in itself, there are not facilities in place like there used to be to keep that cleanliness up. And I think we really need to come down to what is important to those frontline people, what they need to put in place. I am very concerned about the amount of time that nurses and doctors have to spend on paperwork instead of before patients where they're meant to be. And I think these are issues that if we're really going to address the health system, we need to take a serious look at.
Jonathan Coleman, a need to move towards private healthcare?
Well, no, what we're saying is that we need to raise productivity. We need to actually make sure that services are delivered for New Zealanders, and we think if there are some services that can be contracted out to the private sector in a way that produces greater clinical outcomes, provides more services, we think that's a smart use of the private sector. And we don't want to be ideologically bound on this, because the fact is the spending's doubled, but fewer people are getting elective surgery per capita in New Zealand. And, you know, Labor can tell you that everything's wonderful, but people out there, the public on the street, will tell you that the state of our public services, our public hospitals, is worse than ever. And in my electorate, Northcote, I regularly get approached by people whose elderly relatives are having to wait for up to 24, 48 hours on trolleys and hospital corridors. So action is needed. Labor's poured all this money in. We've got more bureaucrats, but fewer services, and the public have absolutely had enough of it.
The people on the street, and I'll come to you in a minute, Louisa, yeah. Of course, that is a real concern, isn't it? There is a perception that New Zealand politicians are not in touch with grassroots New Zealand. Right. They're removed from it. What are each of you people doing to ensure that you are in touch with New Zealand families? If I can begin with you, please, Louisa Wall.
I think I've got an advantage here. I was working in the county's Manukau District Health Board area in Te Kauhi Order, which is the Māori division of the funding and planning area within county's Manukau District Health Board, immediately before I came into Parliament. And one of the huge focuses that the bureaucracies, the DHBs, have been involved with is very much about partnering our communities. It's very much about enabling our communities to start to take responsibility. And particularly in South Auckland, we have huge issues with diabetes and obesity. So there have been the Lotu Moi project, for example, that within the Pacific communities. We have an initiative in County's Manukau District Health Board with the local marae. And it's actually not about the Ministry of Health telling those communities what their problems is. It's actually about getting leaders within those communities to talk to their populations about what their health needs are. And actually the DHBs, the bureaucracies, whatever you want to call them, their job is to supply those resources to the community. Now that sort of philosophical shift has happened under National. It definitely, under a Labor government, I think National conversely would rather business decide what's best for our people. But huge campaigns in terms of Mission On, which is all about ensuring that within a school environment our children are taught and have access to quality food. It's also about encouraging exercise of our children when they are young so that they can develop really good learning practices. So we would say that we're doing a lot to partner New Zealand communities. And there are like chronic issues in South Auckland. I think some of the decentralisation of the funds from the DHB and also having a bureaucracy that enables those community voices to be on the DHBs, you know, in contrast to what the others think. I think that if you're elected onto a DHB, you absolutely have a community voice. Obviously, the minister gets to appoint others who have a different mandate. They usually have a different set of skills. They're either clinicians or they may be accountants or they may have a different philosophy in terms of how the DHB should function.
The question was, how do you keep in touch with the grassroots? And basically, you can't go out there and tell people how great things are under your government. You've actually got to listen to people. Now, I'm an electorate MP. I have clinics every day. I'm talking to New Zealanders who are actually struggling with the healthcare system we have. And we have to be talking to people who are out there, who we are representing, and we have to feed their concerns back up to political leaders and make the appropriate changes. And I tell you, the one thing everyone tells me is that there's too much bureaucracy. When they go to our hospitals, the only thing we seem to have plenty of is managers. There's a manager now for every hospital bed in New Zealand. And you can't tell people how great things are, because when you go out and talk to people, they will tell you the health system is not delivering. And I think we've got to get away from talking about DHBs, wonderful government programs, all this sort of thing, and focus on what New Zealanders are telling us. And they're telling us that they're fed up, and that if after 8 years Labor hasn't fixed the health system, they never will.